Well, hello there. Welcome to the NetHunt CRM extension in Gmail. My name's George, and today I'm going to go through some of the NetHunt basics. I'm going to tell you where NetHunt is in Gmail. I'm going to explain how to auto-link emails in your inbox and create records from them. And I'm going to give you a sneaky peek of our email campaign features, including email tracking. Comfortable? Sweet. Let's get growing. I know what you're wondering. You're wondering where to go next. Well, it's easy. You'll find your workspace on Gmail's left sidebar. And if you don't like where it is, you can change it. You can either have it above your inbox or below it. To change its location, head to the NetHunt settings, find the preferences tab, and choose where you want your workspace to be displayed. Nice. There are loads of sweet things you can do with your new NetHunt extension. Next, we're going to look at how to auto-link your sent and received emails to a relevant contact. This feature centralizes and organizes all of your data. Like, I obviously want to see all my contacts' communication history whenever they email me. So, because there's an email address for that contact in my contacts folder, each email exchange we have is automatically recorded there. Automatic email linking should be switched on by default, but if you want to toggle it for whatever reason, just head to the settings, hit folder and field management, and select the folder you want to customize. Add an email field and make sure your auto-link future emails option is switched on. Alternatively, if you've got incoming mail from a fresh prospect or lead, you can create a new record to keep all their data in. Just click on the NetHunt icon in the subject line. That'll open the record creation menu. Hit create manually, and you'll be able to fill in all that data for a record with all their communication history recorded. Alternatively, you can choose to auto create records when a new name lands in your inbox. Simply hit that option and NetHunt automatically creates a record in your contacts folder, taking your contact's name and email address with it. Once you've got a fair few records in place for your business, you can send out an email campaign. This is a way for you to send multiple emails, rather than having to send them one at a time. Head to the email campaign folder and click New. Name your email campaign, and then choose the folder from which you want to gather your recipient. Decide which view you'd like to see, and then hit the Create Campaign button. After excluding any duplicate addresses from your campaign, hit Continue in the bottom right corner to open the template editor. Write your message and personalize it with Add Macros. This magical little button automatically inserts individual, relevant information like the first name, last name, website, and phone number of your recipient. Before sending the campaign, select the delivery option. You can use Gmail with its 500 email limit per day. You can use NetHunt SMTP with unlimited emails every day. Or you can connect your own custom SMTP. Once you're ready, hit send email campaign and spread the love. And if you're into email campaigns, one more feature we think is particularly useful is the email tracker. Email tracking shows if a recipient received your email, how many times they viewed it, and whether they followed a link included in that email. Whatever your business, email tracking helps you measure engagement for your email campaigns to create relevant follow-ups. To track your sent emails, head to settings and then preferences. There, you'll find two buttons for email open tracking and link click tracking. Enable them to have the options available to you in your Gmail Compose window. Alternatively, you can fill the checkbox if you want your emails to be tracked automatically. Now, when you compose an email, you'll find two icons at the bottom of that Compose window. The eye icon is your open stats, telling you who opened your emails. The pointing finger icon is your clicks, showing you who clicked links in your email. Make sure they're enabled before you hit that send button. Afterwards, you can check on the progress of any sent email in your sendbox. Hit the eye icon or the green icon with a time frame inside it. If this green time frame icon shows your email has been opened, the time frame within it shows how long ago it was opened. Easy peasy. Finally, when you've fired out your fair share of email campaigns, your inbox starts to get a little bit too hot to handle. Record snippets help tidy things up a little bit. They're color-coded previews of every record in your inbox, offering a snapshot of what's going on in your business. When you click a snippet, it'll send you straight to the record. To set up snippets, go to the folder settings and choose the fields you want to see as a snippet. We'd actually recommend not having full records there. Otherwise, it becomes messy and difficult to read. And that's not a snippet. Finally, activate the option Show in Record Snippet. Well, that wasn't too bad, was it? You're all set up with your NetHunt Gmail extension. And that's all from me. Stay tuned with the NetHunt Academy to learn more about your new CRM system. I'm sure I'll be seeing you around.